finally made it out here to the first island. There's a lot of birds moving. On the one line I had the 7-inch husky jerk. On the other, about a 5-inch Rapala shad deep diver. I'm gonna have to cut back through here. The current's flowing just too well in this direction, in between here and here. That's an excellent funnel for the fish. The waves out here, I gotta be honest, are a little bigger than I expected for today. I think it must be because of the direction in which they're blowing. They're blowing more or less straight out of the north, which gives the winds just free rein to build up momentum. My experience is usually a lot better, a lot calmer, when the winds are blowing out of the west or the east. But we gonna be all right. Because the winds forecasted for today, at their peak, are around 5 miles an hour. And they're supposed to be lower than that for the duration of the morning. So I'm not gonna worry about the wind just yet. But I'll turn this back on once the fish start biting. Right about when I get my boat to the point of the island, or adjacent to the point of the island, that seems to be where I'm catching most of my fish, and where I'm hooking up. Right about here is where they are, but I'm trolling through it. And I'm using about a 4-inch Rapala shad deep imitation. And it seems to be matching these forage fish pretty damn well. These fish are bumping and biting the hell out of it. Alright, I start watching close now. Could be any moment. Whoop, there he is. Fish on. Fish on. Ooh, good fish. Good fish. Good fish. She definitely feels. Yep, that's a keeper. That's a keeper fish if I can get her. Oh hell. I'm in a bad way now. I'm in a bad way now. Oh, I'm tangled up on everything. Come on. Get in the net. Get in the net. Okay, I got her. It's a mess, but I got her. And I'm pretty sure she'll go 20. Yep. Fish on. Fish on. Might be a better one here. Either that or he's foul hooked. It's mostly a foul hook. Fish on. Fish on. Like I suspected. Nice thick little fatty. But she's not gonna go 20. Fish on. Fish on. Feels decent. I wrapped up in a liner. No, there she is. Fish on and it feels big. This feels like a big fish. A part of it is that she was snagged. Damn it. Damn foul hooks. That's why she felt so big. Son of a gun. Fooled me good, little beauty. Fooled me real good. Not what I was trying to do.
I don't know. It might be a 17 or 18 incher, maybe. Let's see you, little beauty. Let's see you. Come on. There she is. Yeah, about what I said.
Oh, fish on. Fish on. Feels pretty good. That wasn't even the rod I was expecting. Nice fish. Could be. Could be a keeper. Might be a little bit short. Might be another 18, 19 incher. There she is. Boy, I tell you, what a day. What a freaking day, man. Whew. And she ate it. Look at that. Oh no, you're all bloody. Oh no, girl. You swallowed that, didn't you? There we go. Hooks out easy. There you go. Good luck. Oh, there he is. Fish on. Fish on. Yes, sir. Yeah. I do it every weekend, brother. Fish on. Oh. That's a pretty good fish. I better net her. That's a keeper. I do indeed. Feels good. Feels pretty good. She's close. Should be borderline. Have to measure this one. There she is. What a fatty. What a fatty. What a fat, fat, fatty. Oh, he had it. Or he bumped it, one of the two. Oh, damn. Damn, they're bumping the f*** out of it. There we go. There's a fish. There, she's on that time. Man, she was bumping, they were bumping the hell out of the lure. I mean, bumping the hell out of it. In with no tangles. Yeah. Alright, buddy. Let's get you off of here. First. There she is. Fish on. There's like another good fish. If it was legal to keep three, this one would be coming home, I'm pretty sure. I'm pretty sure this is another keeper fish. Yeah. There you are, gorgeous. Fish on. Feels good. Definitely feels like a good fish. These fish are stacked. I mean stacked in here. It's a keeper fish. That's a keeper fish. Here she comes. Here she comes. There she is. There she is. Got her. Got her. Actually, I don't know if she's a keeper or not. She might just be a real fatty. I think she'll go about 18 and a half. Maybe 19. She's just a real fatty. Look at the back on her. Boy, if it weren't for this law, that'd be a good eating fish. Right there, 18 and a half. I can understand your apprehension, but this is actually the part that you want. And I'll take that today. the hell? I think I have another fish on. Danger of running this many rods though. Yeah, this one feels better too. Doubled up. Doubled up. That's definitely the better fish. Between the two, that's definitely the better fish. Just gotta make sure I get them both in without losing a rod. This one I better net. She's close. I don't know if she'll keep or not, but she's close. There we go. Hell yeah. I was worried about getting skunked. Whew. There's one. Stab it, stab it, stab it. You officially entered the danger zone. Go. One rod there, one rod here. Gorgeous fish. Thank you. Thank you. All right, on the way back from fishing today, and I can't lie, it was an awesome day, man. It was freaking awesome. Especially for being in December. It's December 11th today. Man. Madness. Absolute madness. But yeah, anyway. I hit the Bay Bridge this morning. I got about 24 striper between about 14 and 22 inches. From about 7 until about 10 in the morning. A quick recap of the gear I was using for anyone interested. Both rods are essentially medium action. Same with the reels. I don't pay too much attention to the stats on the reels and rods. Aside from them being medium action, medium gear. The fishing line on one was, I think, about 15 pound braid. The line on the other was only 7 pound sun line. And on each of them I was trolling, one had a Rapala shad deeper, and the other had a Husky jerk, I think 7 inches. Tore them up, man. Tore those fish up. Whew. Buddy, good times.